Hello, this is going to be a video explanation letting you know what exactly you have to do for your amendment storyboard that.com project, right? So I have already given you the instructions in class. It looks like something like this. So it says in this mini project, you will be creating a 10 box meme slash comic book storyboard using the storyboardthat.com website. I have already emailed you the link, so the link will be in your email. If you do not have the For some reason, the link is also on the website. I'm going to show you where to find that. If you are not sure what to do on this project based on the explanation that I give you, you should be watching this video. Slowly go back, rewatch the parts where you're not sure of. Your job will be to represent the meaning of each amendment per box. So 10 boxes, 10 amendments. It could either be a meme, a comic strip, or any other interesting interaction that shows that you understand the rights that are protected in that amendment. I gave you scenarios when we explained it in class. You could take that scenario and make it into one of these boxes. Each box will have a background, and I'll show you in a minute what that means. The background, they give you tons of them on the website, or you could upload pictures if you like. Minimum one character per box. You could add as many characters as you want. There would be one comment box per character, though. So that means that if you're gonna have an interaction, like a conversation between two people, they need to each have a comment box on top, and there will be one text box at the bottom that gives me your one sentence definition of what that amendment is. You must save at the end your storyboard as a PDF on the desktop. Now, if you're using the Chromebooks from class, you must save it on the desktop and email it to yourself because you will not be able to get it the next day. But if you save it on the actual website, you could always log on to another computer, and when you log in, your storyboard will be there for you to print it, because this must be printed out and it must be ready to be turned in. Make sure you print landscape. You know, portrait is when it's up and, you know, more. I'll show you in a minute, but make sure it's landscape, and for so all 10 boxes could be on one page. Then you put your name and period and you turn it in on the due date. All right, so let's get started with showing you what to do. All right, so first what we're going to do is we're going to go to my website, and here it is. And you could already see here, this is the amendment story link. I emailed it to you, but if for some reason you didn't get the email, you could just come here and click on it. This is the video that you're watching now. So we're going to click on it, and it's going to open up this link. Now it's going to ask you to sign in. For you guys, it'll probably be a box before that says sign in with Google. And you click on the Google, and then it's going to ask you to sign in. So you're going to click on your Google, which is your school issued email and password, and then you are going to log in. When you log in, it's going to look something like this. All right, and what you're going to do is you're going to create your first storyboard. So you're going to click on here. Now, when you click on here, it gives you three boxes, but we're not doing three boxes. We're doing 10, right? Because we have 10 amendments. So what you're going to do is you're going to add cells, and when this box pops up, you want it to be two rows of five. So you can see right here, five times two. Five times two equals 10, like the 10 amendments. And then you update the storyboard. When you do, you can see there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now you must make these amendment 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Each one has to have a background or a scene, right? So you can see the scenes. There's tons of different scenes, and every time you click on a scene, it gives you different types of backgrounds. So let's go to here. We're gonna take one from here. All you do is click on it, and then you just drag it and you drop it, and it's there. Right, we're going to country and rustic, find one and put this one right here for this one, and it just drops it. We're going to put this one over here for the third amendment. We're going to go to this one right here, and we're going to get this one, and we're going to put it for the fourth amendment. You just have to go through them and find which one is going to fit your meme. So right here, all I'm doing is adding every single one of them. Go entertainment, everyone has different scenes, and then you're just going to drop them, find the ones that you that are going to benefit you the most. Find the ones that are going to make help you explain exactly what you're trying to do with your amendment meme or amendment comic strip. You can make it funny, you can make an interesting story like a scenario, the ones that I use in class, or you can make it a meme where you're trying to send a point by the messages that you put on there. All right, so each one will have a background. As you can see, I added all 10 already. Then you need to put a character in each one, minimum one character, and again it has tons of options. So I'm going to put this character right here, and see when you drop him, well, you drop him, you can go to here, the box, and you can make him move around, or you can make it smaller, like this, depending on where you want to put him. So I'm going to put him right here. Then you can see you can change the hair color, the skin color. So hair color, let's make it an orange hair. All right, and he's going to have a little bit browner hair, a browner skin look, and then he's going to have blah, just whatever. right? Now you put it in and you can modify exactly the way you want it to look. So there's your one character per thing. And then you're gonna put one here, wherever you're gonna do. Make sure it looks like it's part of the actual item. You have this one right here. And then you're gonna go to, there's other ones. So you could get all kinds of different characters. You're gonna put this one right here. So yeah, I'm just gonna put one per. All right, and then you're gonna go to just check out the options that are there. So you could, let's use a ghost, put the ghost over here so you can actually see it. Okay, and then, like I said, one per. So choose the ones that you think are gonna best work for what you're trying to say. And there's so many different categories, and they have so many of them that you could just put one on each one. And just put this one here. And then we'll just go to this one. As you can see, there's also a group one. So if you want to do this, you could put it like this. Like if it was a group conversation, you could put a thought bubble for each one. When you go to textables, here's where you're going to be able to put one of these thought bubbles, right? And you're going to be able to put it like this. And then here is where you're going to be able to type something, whatever you need to explain your mean your amendment, right? As you can see, there it goes. All right, so there's different versions of it. So if you want to put one down like this instead, you want to put two characters like this, and you want to put one bubble down here, make it a little smaller so it fits, and then you want to put the other one up here like this. So now you can have a conversation between these two people to show me what the Fourth Amendment is. All right, so it has to have a background, has to have a person in each one, and then it has to have thought bubbles for a person. Now you're also going to be able to put a shape because I need you to get this shape right here, which is the, where's it at? Probably the square or the rectangle, because you are going to be putting it somewhere at the bottom like this. No, that's not it. Which one is it? All right, hold on. Textables. Let's go back to objects. Okay, so these are the ones that I'm talking about. So don't go to shapes, go to decorative, and you bring this in, and then you put it right here. And here you could type in your one sentence summary. There's one sentence, yeah, definition of that amendment. All right, and that goes somewhere down here. So you're gonna have to put something like that, right? And as you can see, the font's a little small, so make it 12, make it a little bit bigger, and hopefully it looks a little bit better. See, as you can see, now you can clearly see what it is. All right, so again, there has to be a background. There has to be at least one person, or you could put two. Each person has to have a thought bubble, and you have to have your shape. Again, your deck, so you're still at textables, but I went to decorative, or you could go to shapes. So if you just want the rectangle that I was looking for before, you just put it there, and then you could type in whatever here and just stretch it out, and there's your definition. All right, so I'm gonna choose one really quick to show you what exactly I would do. All right, so I'm going to choose this one right here. All right, and I have one person now. I have my pirate guy here, and then I'm going to add another character. I don't care who. So I'm just going to put this guy right here. Okay, now if I put two people, again, I have to have two thought bubbles. Now, what I'm trying to do is, okay, how could I show that these two are having a conversation about the Eighth Amendment? All right, so I need to make sure I have enough room that I have a thought bubble for each one. So then again, I go to textables, I go to the speech ones, and I'm gonna get one of these that, let's see, like this one, and he's gonna be right here, and he's gonna say something like, "Hey, I thought they arrested you. Why aren't you in jail?" Okay, So you're having a conversation. Now this guy's gonna answer because you're gonna put another textable for him, and you're gonna write something like, "Yes, they did, but luckily the Eighth Amendment gives me the chance." Gives me the chance for bail. All right. So now you put that there. Now, so far you've shown me the background, the two images. You set up a question, and then this guy answered it. Now the only thing we need is the actual textable. So then I could insert again textables, but I'm gonna go with shapes, and I'm gonna go with this one. I'm gonna put this one right here, and then I'm gonna text the. I'm gonna say. This I get, no, let me see. This amendment protects my right to receive bail and no cruel and unusual punishments. Okay, so I'm a little long there, so that means that I'm gonna have to somehow figure out how I'm gonna put my box, stretch it out a little bit, and see now I can put it right here in the corner. And now when I look at my box, I have a background, I have a character, I have two characters. I have a thought, I mean a speech box for each one of them, and I have my box that tells me what the amendment is, my one sentence summary of definition of this amendment. This is what I want to see for all 10. All right? Background, character, thought bubble, two characters, two thought bubbles, box, definition of each one in your own words. All right? Now that you are done, say you've done all 10 of them, now it's time to save it. All right? So we're going to click save. And what that's gonna do is you're gonna have to put a name on it. Okay, so it's a sample. And then I'll put this there for now, sample as well. And then save storyboard. Okay, when you click on that, it's saving it on the website right now. What it's also gonna do is it's gonna allow you to save it as a PDF. All right, or download, I'm sorry. You're gonna download like PDF. So you click on download, and then you go to PDF, and you click on that. And now it's taking this and downloading it like a PDF. It's just taking its time. Download PDF. Okay, here it is. All right, so you can see it's a PDF now. So I want you to save it on your desktop. Now, if you save it on the desktop of the Chromebooks, it might not, it most likely won't be there the next day. So if you're using your computer, then you're fine. But if you're using the one there and you save it on the desktop, sample, you click save. Now it's saved on the desktop, it's saved on the website. And if you want to email it to yourself, then you have to go open up your email. When you open up your email, you're going to compose, even though your name is going to be already at the top, you also send it to yourself. So I'm sending it to the same email that I'm logged in with, and I put a sample, and then I have to attach it. And then I'm going to go to the desktop, and there is a sample. And then I open it, and it attaches it. As you can see, it's closely attaching it. And now you hit send. And whenever you log into whatever email, you're just going to, whatever computer to print it out, here's the email. Just click on there, and you're able to hit print. If you don't do this step, you at least can go back to your storyboards. And you could log in again to the same link that I sent here. So if I click on this link, see now that I'm logged in, it's gonna click in and it's gonna tell me, it's gonna take me directly to the one I just did. And then I could go from there and I could hit print on the computer I'm using, and then it so and then you're able to print. All right. Now if you're printing like the PDF, like you're from your email. So like we were here at the email, so you emailed it to yourself, you click on it. So it's going to open up the PDF, the one that we did already. This one. All right, so it's going to open up this. I want you to hit print. And what I meant by landscape is when you hit print, it's going to give you the options. You're going to choose the printer here, if it's in the computer lab or if it's in the library or if it's at home. But here down here where it says orientation, I want you to do landscape. Because see, now it's able to put it on one page. With portrait, it put it on one page, but it has to be a lot smaller. And I don't want it to be this small. I want them to be bigger. So when you put landscape, it stretches it out because the paper is sideways versus up and down. And then you hit print, and you're able to print it, put your name in period, and turn it in. Hopefully this explains.